Today, I'm going to show you new capabilities on Office 365 to help you easily create accessible content. These include accessible templates in Office for PCs and Macs, auto-generated descriptions for images and titles for hyperlinks, as well as how Word for Mac now creates accessible PDFs. In Office 365, we're making it easier for you to ensure your content is usable by people with disabilities. Let's start with PowerPoint. Accessible templates are a great way to get started. A simple search for accessible returns all of the templates that we've recently upgraded for accessibility. Today, I want to make a business plan, so let me add that to the scope of my search. This plan looks good. Let me open it and show you what exactly makes it accessible. To do this, I'm going to switch to the slide outline view so you can see how every slide here has a unique title. As I update the text, the labeling and the formatting is automatically taken care of, making this deck easy to navigate for someone who is a keyboard user and a screen reader user. For example, this slide, every element is easy to navigate using a keyboard because we have thought through tab order. Similarly, in this slide, if I open a screen reader called Narrator, you can hear how it's read out to someone who's blind.
Volume mute. Title text box, editing. Content placeholder 5, chart, cluster column. Bar chart shows cost analysis, with y-axis displaying expenditure in currency and x-axis indicating a respective category in which the amount was spent. Bar chart shows cost analysis.
What you just heard Narrator reading out is a description of this chart that was provided by the author in a field called alt text. Alt text is another field that we're making much easier to use. Let me show you a new service that we're designing to make alt text easier to use by opening a blank presentation and inserting a picture. Now, when I right-click on this image and select automatic alt text, I can generate a description for this image using our Cognitive Services API. In this case, the service figures out that this image is a group of people standing on a football field. If my intention for this image was different, I can alter this by typing some extra words. With machine learning, the service will keep improving the more that people use it. In addition to alt text and the work we're doing with templates, we're also making it easier to work with hyperlinks and create accessible documents. Here, I have Word on my PC open. I'm working on a report. Notice that every heading in this paper is using the default styles that are built into Word. These are designed to be easy to navigate with a screen reader and have sufficient color contrast. In addition, if I insert a new hyperlink in any section of this document, I can use the link gallery, which shows me a list of most recently used files. When I insert a link from here, it automatically uses the file name as the display text. This is much more accessible than including a URL. One more thing I want to show you is the accessibility checker, now discoverable from the Review tab. This scans my document and shows me any errors that might make it difficult for someone with a disability to use my document. Clicking on the error takes me to the place where the error has occurred, as well as shows me why to fix the error and how to fix it. It also gives me a link to learn more about this type of error. We've recently brought the accessibility checker to more PC apps, such as OneNote, and also to Office web apps and Office for Mac. Additionally, in Word for Mac, we're introducing a service to export a stacked PDF via Save As, so screen reader users can navigate exported documents by sections, understand images, and access hyperlinks. These are a few updates to help you author your files with accessibility in mind. We'll continue adding new capabilities to help advance digital inclusion. To stay up to date, search accessibility in Office blogs, and keep checking back to the Microsoft Mechanics Accessibility playlist. Thank you for watching.